Thank you. everyone. Welcome to St. James Church as we celebrate the sacrament of holy matrimony, the life of Dana and James. As we begin all things, we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. And please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come, of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living beings, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I am boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interest, it is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community of your family and friends, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated in holy matrimony and holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. So, my dear friends, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. James and Dana, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I am.
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church.
Sorry.
I, James, take you, Dana.
To be my lawful wife.
To be my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
in sickness and in health.
To love. And to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Okay.
I, Dana, take you, James. For my lawful husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love.
And to cherish.
Until death do us part. May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church, and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessings within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. Bless, O Lord, these rings which we bless in your name, so that those who bear them may remain entirely faithful to each other, abide in peace and in your will, and live always as in mutual charity, through Christ our Lord.
Dana, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
James, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, and that the effects of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by us all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and blessing in you and your children. Amen. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad. Amen. May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts. Amen. And may Almighty God bless all of you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. My dear friends, it's my great privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. James and Dana Walsh.
in store for you, but first up, we need to introduce our bridal party. First up, ladies and gentlemen, we have the parents of the bride, Patricia and Albert Bingley. And next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have the parents of the groom, Jim and Kathleen Walsh. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our bridal party. First up, we have our bridesmaid, Jessica, with groomsman, Ryan. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to announce our maid of honor, Crystal, and the best man, Ryan. And ladies and gentlemen, if you can please rise to your feet and please put your hands together for the new Mr. and Mrs. Dana and James Wall. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the middle of our dance floor as our bride and groom cut the cake. Ladies and gentlemen, direct your attention to the middle of our dance floor once again as our bride and groom join hands for their very first dance. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Mr. and Mrs. Walsh. And now I would like to turn the microphone over for a few kind words and our welcoming toast from her father, Mr. Albert.
Dana, you've been the star of my life for 30-something years now. And James, I know you're going to take real good care of her. Protect her and make sure everything goes real well. And Trish, Jim, and Kathy are so happy that you two have found one another. And are going to work hard to live the American dream. And you're going to find a few bumps down the road. But I guarantee after 30 years, they flatten right out. So it'll be just fine. Just you got to get there. That's all. So let's have a toast to Dana and James Walsh.
And next up is the father of our groom, Mr. Jim.
Just to extend a little bit from where the priest started today and talking about sort of the, you know, all the new rules we have and impositions on our life and things that made the decision to be here a lot more difficult than it would be for a normal wedding. So I really appreciate your stubbornness, your commitment. You know what a lot of people would say, you know, it was a really tough idea in these times, but thanks to your youth, naivete, here we are. And it's given us all an opportunity to reemerge, right, from where we've been for a few months. And if we don't have your commitment to each other to do that, we don't have this opportunity maybe for who knows how long. So I love you for that. I love you for letting us all come out today, not just to be with you guys, but to get on with our lives. I love you for that. I'm going to finish with one of my dad's favorite toasts. He's an Irishman, got off the boat in 1952 and brought us our life in America. But he says, may God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be poor in misfortune and rich in blessing. And may you know nothing but happiness. God bless you.
Thank you, Mr. Walsh. And next up is our matron of honor.
Okay. Okay. Right. Good evening, everyone. I hope you're all having a wonderful time celebrating these two lovebirds here. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Crystal, and Dana and I are best friends. We have known each other for many years, and luckily, through a mutual friend, have been by each other's side ever since we met. I actually met James first. We went to middle school together, but never thought I'd be speaking at his wedding, but here we are. But seriously, James and Dana, I hope the next chapter for you two is one from a fairy tale. Okay. Filled with love and happiness, each day better than the next. Dana is more than my best friend. She's literally my sister. And I'm beyond grateful to be here on a special day with all of you. So if everyone could raise their glasses to Dana and James, may the years ahead be brighter than ever. I love you.
My name's Ryan, not to be confused with Dana's brother, whose also name is Ryan. It's a good name. I'd like to say congratulations to James and Dana. I've known James in sixth grade, so a lot of good times together. And his mom and dad, Jim and Kathy, were always like a second family to me growing up. I have a quick story. I was actually there when James and Dana first met. I had just got back from overseas and met up with James. We were out and about in town, and I remember saying to him, I think that woman keeps looking at you. And as soon as I said that, he walked right over. There was no hesitation at all, and just he introduced himself, and I'm just so happy for the both of them, and cheers. Cheers.
Thank you, Ryan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to bless the food this evening, if I could ask for the grandfather of the bride.
Grandsons are one thing, and I just got another one. But granddaughters, oh yeah, there's something else. Whatever they ask you, you have to do. And that's just no other way about it. My granddaughter asked me to say grace. And I couldn't be more pleased to say grace at a place like this and for two people like these two. The grace I want to say is a very simple one, and I want my wife, Betty Jean, to stand up with me because she taught me that prayer. Huh? Bless, O Lord, the needs and thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
At this time, I would like to invite our bride and her father onto the dance floor for the father and daughter dance. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the Bingleys and their lovely daughter, Dana. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the mother and son dance. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the Walshes. Ooh, 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 ooh. And now I need all my married couples to please join our bride and groom on the dance floor. Married longer than 24 hours, you are asked to exit the dance floor. How about 1 year? 1 year of marriage. 2 years of marriage. 5 years of marriage. God, speed your love to lucky number eight. 8 years of marriage. Ten years. About 15 years of marriage. To the open arms of the sea. 20 years of marriage.
Wait for me, wait for me. I'll be coming home.
25 years of marriage. About 28 years of marriage. Hunger, hunger. 30 years of marriage. Oh, 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 no. 32. Oh, 35. And 39. Oh,
and do so much. Are you too much?
And ladies and gentlemen, 62 years of marriage. 62 years of marriage. Congratulations and blessings to you both. And ladies and gentlemen, one more time, please give it up for 62 years.